Hi, welcome to the PDF Builder DocuSign integration. Okay, to use DocuSign and to automate your sending via PDF Builder, you need to create an extra field on the opportunity in this case, because this is the object we are sending from. So on this opportunity, I've created an extra formula field, and this is actually the link that you have to generate. This is not PDF Butler. We will make it much simpler. So if you want to see another digital signing tool that has a much better integration with PDF Butler, please check out Sign Butler. That's our own document generation tool. Perfectly legal signing of a digital signing of your documents, just as DocuSign. The DocuSign requires this kind of link to be generated. What's in this link? It's the role that's there. It's the decision maker role, that's the signer, the email address, and you see that we concatenated with a related field on our opportunity. So if we take a look on our opportunity, there is this primary contact, and this is the person that's actually going to sign it. This is the configuration for one single signer. If you have multiple signers, okay, then you have to create, of course, multiple signers and make sure that these signers and all these items there are updated. The first name, so in the first name, there cannot be any spaces there, so I substitute the spaces with any pluses. Last name, same thing there, I substituted the spaces with the pluses. If you want to do a sign now, then perfectly possible, you can just sign now in DocuSign means that immediately go to a signing screen. You don't want to you don't want to send it out, or you have a direct action sent, for instance, in this case. So it means we don't want to check out our document. We immediately want to send it out. And then where DocuSign is really not that dynamic in its automated sending is that you have to select here via this property if you want to select attachments or files. So if you select LF here, it's files. If it's LA, then it's attachments. It means that it will take all attachments or all files from your document. So nothing we can do about that one. If you have more attachments, but you only want to select the latest one, that's in this, as far as I know, not possible. If you have any more input, please add it to our YouTube comments. And of course, we are no specialists of DocuSign. We are specialists in PDF Butler and in Sign Butler. If there are more capabilities on DocuSign that we are not aware of, please add it to our posts on our YouTube so people can enjoy your knowledge as well. Cool. I will make sure this entire string ends up with our comments in YouTube, so people, you can just copy that one. Now we have this configuration, we have this information here. So now let's use that in PDF Butler to set up DocuSign. So in PDF Butler, what we are going to create is a new pack, like always, and it's gonna be a DocuSign demo pack. So you just give it a name. You add to it the doc config that you want to use. So in this case, we want to create our car quote and send that out via DocuSign, which seems normal. Then, of course, we need some actionable. So, and the actionable should say the class has to be DocuSign. Actionable underscore DocuSign. Mind the upper and lower casing. This is very important. It's an after actionable, means that it will run when the generation of the doc config is completed. It has to be active. It's linked to our pack, of course. And then we have to get our information. So we know that we need some kind of a data source. So that's our car opportunity. This is the data source that DocuSign will need. Find the information here. So it will use that in its query string to actually find all the information required. And we will also need to put in the field, the parameter that we will get that we need for this. This is this extra field that we have created, and we need this parameter to send out automatically in a single click our document towards DocuSign to get it signed. Okay. So means also that this data source needs to include this field as well. If it doesn't include it, of course, you will get an error because this field is mandatory, and we need that input to post it further to DocuSign. Cool. So our pack is done, our setup is done. Now we just add here a PDF Butler component like this one. So if you see here, edit page. I have a bunch of these components on here, so just for all the demos that we are giving and preparing. And you can see here that we have the ID of our pack, so that is this ID. That's the actionable DocuSign demo. It's this ID, so that's this ID. The name of our pack. We don't want to do any merging, so only these fields have to be added, have to be filled in. Okay, our pack is there. We have our primary contact, that's Jeff English, who's gonna be our the responsible person for sending out. So everything is set, we know what to do. And now what we're going to do is just simply click this button. First step that will be done is actually that it will generate the document. That went very fast. And now it's sending that generated document towards DocuSign to get it signed. So we are already generated the document and forwarded to DocuSign. All goes automatic. Yeah, as I said, if we have this this click occurrence here, this on click action set to send, we are not going to have to pass any DocuSign screens anymore. It's immediately sent out. So very cool. Our document is sent. I've already received an email. You might have heard it. So I see my email here that I have a document to check, and I need to go to DocuSign to get it signed. So for the rest, all of it's a standard DocuSign configuration and setting. If you want to have the information sent back to Salesforce, all of that is DocuSign, of course. Yeah, check out the document DocuSign configuration for all of that information. So let's take a look in the DocuSign app. If I refresh this one and get the DocuSign statuses, I want to see them all, of course. So you see that at this moment, it's very late in the evening. I have created my my DocuSign record here. So now I can follow this one up. It's related to my account, to my opportunity. It has my sender email here. That's the person that that sent it out. So everything seems to be perfectly okay. All of the information is there. It's sent out. It's there. So this is our DocuSign demo. If you want to set it up, yeah, be our guest. If you want to check out Sign Butler, again, I have to mention it. It's our own product. Please do, and you can compare, and you can see what's the difference. Thank you very much.